Hi everyone, now we can discuss pressure distribution in rotating fluid. Consider a tube of length L containing some liquid inside. If you take some three points at the same horizontal level, let me name it as 1, 2, 3, calculating the pressure at three different points will give the same answer, that is P1 is equal to P2 is equal to P3. This is because at same horizontal level when the fluid is at rest, the pressure will be also same. If the same tube of length L, when it is rotated about some axis, about vertical axis, horizontally with angular speed omega, and if I take those three different points inside the liquid or fluid, you can take the pressure at these three different points which is taken at the same level horizontally will not have the same pressure. This is because of rotation of the fluid, and why it is pressure distribution is different at different points and how to calculate the pressure at various points in the rotating fluid, that we are going to discuss in this session. Consider this fluid is having a density of rho. So due to this horizontal rotation, a circular motion will be produced in this tube. So due to this, the fluid inside the tube will experience a centrifugal force, that is a outward force in this direction. So this is a direction of centrifugal force. Due to this centrifugal force, the fluid which is inside the tube will form a parabolic shape in this end if this end is open. If this end is open, due to this outward centrifugal force, the fluid which are all present here will tend to move outside, so that this end will have a parabolic shape of the liquid. And if I calculate the pressure at this point, let me take this point as A, and this PA will have the atmospheric pressure. And if we take the point here, which is at a distance of x from the axis of rotation, let me name this point as B. And what is the pressure at this point B? And this pressure at B will not be same as A, because due to this centrifugal force, the pressure at each and every point will be different because of this centrifugal force. To calculate the pressure at the point B, which is at a distance of x, first let us consider a small liquid column. This can be taken at a distance r from the axis of rotation, and the length of the small liquid column is dr. And this small liquid column is also experiencing some pressure difference because of from both the sides. This pressure difference we can name it as dP. So to find out the pressure difference, you know some general formula, that is dP is equal to h rho A. Normally what you have been learning so far is dP is equal to h rho g. Here g we will take only when the pressure is calculated along the vertical directions. Here we are not considering any gravity, and the acceleration is along horizontal directions. So instead of g, here you can take this as a. This a is nothing but what? A centrifugal acceleration. And here h, normally it is the height of the liquid column, but as we are considering it in a horizontal direction, here we are going to take h as a length of the liquid column. Here h will denote dr and a is nothing but what? A centripetal acceleration, and rho, it is the density of the fluid. Then we can rewrite this as dp is equal to dr into rho, and this a is called what? Centrifugal acceleration, and for this small liquid column it is experiencing some centripetal acceleration a. So to calculate the centripetal or centrifugal acceleration, this formula is omega square r, here r is the distance from the axis of rotation. So if we integrate, integration of dp, rho omega square, integration of r dr, and if you want to apply the limit, so here our motive is to find the pressure at B, and here this is the starting point A, so lower limit will be PA and the upper limit will be PB, and this lower limit let it be at the distance L1, and this B is at a distance X. Now when you integrate, this will become PB minus PA is equal to rho omega square r square by 2 L1 x. This PB is minus, this PA is nothing but what? It is atmospheric pressure, which is equal to rho omega square by 2, this we can write it as x square minus L1 square. So PB is equal to atmospheric pressure plus 1 by 2 rho omega square x square minus L1 square. This is the pressure at the point B. If suppose this is not the open end and this liquid is not forming any parabolic shape here, in that case this atmospheric pressure, as it is a closed end, this atmospheric pressure will be zero and it will not form any parabolic shape. In this case L1 square also will become zero. Then in that case, for closed end, PB will be equal to 1 by 2 rho omega square x square. This is the required expression for finding the pressure at this point B. Thank you.